Welcome to another quality tutorial from Peavitz Labs. Today, we will show you how to install SmartFoxServer and get started with the multiplayer shooter demo for Unity. This video will show you how to install SmartFox on your computer, where to add the shooter extension code, and how to configure the shooter project within the Unity editor. Let's start by downloading SmartFox from the SmartFox website. For this example, we will select Windows. Be sure to read the instructions as you may have security issues when downloading. The installation could not be more simple. Just select Install and follow the instructions. That's all there is to it. Next, download the Unity Examples pack, unzip, and navigate to the Shooter folder. Select the Shooter extension from the Deploy folder as shown. Drag or copy this and place it in a folder labeled Shooter in the SmartFox extension folder, as we have done here. Now you can start the server software from your Windows menu. Open a browser window and start the SmartFox server admin tool. Add the extension to the basic example zone and check that UDP is enabled. Next, open your Unity Hub and navigate to the Shooter Client folder where you will see Assets, Packages, and the Project Settings folders. Add this to the Unity Hub as a project from disk and open it. The Unity Editor may take a while to start, as it will need to add all the required packages. But when it is done, you should be able to click Play, and everything should work without any errors. First, we will take a look at the game scene and see where we can change any configurable parameters. Select the Game Manager in the Hierarchy window, and let's take a look at the configurable settings in the Inspector window. You can expand each of the sections as needed. The Character settings is where you can add different character prefabs and change the random colors assigned to each character. In the network settings, you can select simple or complex for the sync mode. Simple will work fine when you have the SmartFox software on a local computer. But when you move it to an internet server, you will need to change this to complex. This will compensate for any network lag. The input action asset is where you can add and configure your Unity input settings for different devices. Check the Unity documentation on how to set this up. This demo uses the Unity Cine Machine to control the player camera. We have coded three camera views, first, second, and third. You can adjust the camera position offset from here. If you want to add your own UI canvas, you will need to drag in your elements into the UI settings section. This works the same as any UI interface and should be easy to understand. Finally, we have the audio settings. You can change the sounds by dragging in your own audio clips. Now select the login scene from the project window and navigate to the login controller in the inspector window. You will see that the host is set to 127.0.0.1. This is fine if you are testing, but if you wish to play with others on the local network, you will need to change this to the IP address of the computer that is running the SmartFox software. Finally, when you want to deploy a build to play over the internet, you will need to move the SmartFox software to an internet server and change the host setting in the login controller to the server name. Doing a Unity build should be straightforward. You can build this demo for Windows or Mac, but not WebGL. WebGL does not support UDP, which is what this example is using for the network protocol. In the next tutorial, we will show you how to add your own characters to this example. Don't forget to subscribe and support Peavitz Labs by joining us on our Patreon site.